Hi, welcome to my channel, the Machine Learning Engineer. Today in this video, I'm carrying out an experiment with the new model of Microsoft, the FI3, the version mini with the 4,000 tokens of context window. This experiment is pretty much the same I've been doing with other models, recent models like Mistral 7B, Llama 2 7 billions as well, and Llama 3 8 billions. On those, I just send some prompts in this specific topic where the models usually doesn't perform very well, and you can test, you can take a look to the other experiments I carried out with those other models. And well, after that case that was necessary, I also fine-tuned the models with a specialized data set in COT, chain of truth, and repeat the experiment with the fine-tuned model. In this case, as you will see, it's not going to be necessary to fine-tune the model. It's performing extremely well for the comparison or considering the size of the model. Well, we will cover this through once we review the video. So I will pass you some of the relevant information about the model, what Microsoft had published regarding the benchmarks and the comparison with other models. The FI3 comes in three different four. Well, this is the FI2 version. It's likely the previous version of this one we are testing today. And as you can see, it comes in three different versions with Mini, with this 3.8 billion, really small model. Small 7 billion and medium 14 billion of the tokens. You can see here comparisons in different benchmarks with the other models, all of them bigger than them. Than at least the one we tried today is the Mini with 4K. There is another version with 128,000 of context windows, which is really impressive for the size of the model. And you can see here the comparison with models bigger than this: Mistral, Gemma, Llama, Mistral 8 Plus 7B. You can see all of them is even close to the GPT 3.5 in many of the benchmarks. Some of them are even better. Compare the size of this model in comparison with GPT 3.5. It's 250 times smaller, and the performance in some of the benchmarks are about. If you take a look to the median, which is it's 70 times smaller than the GPT 3.5, and this is performing really, really much better than the GPT 3.5. But again, today we are covering the and again, well, just I will provide you the link. Well, it's public, you can find it in Hugging Face. So, but again, take a look to the performance. So many of these benchmarks, they are even better, even using this small model in comparison with GPT. Obviously, this model is very recent. It's probably released 3 months ago, and GPT 3.5 is 2.5 years ago. So it's the techniques used by Microsoft in this case are quite state of the art, modern, and Something that we already discussed on the channel, that how this is progressing every day a smaller model, more powerful, that you can run it in a conventional GPU. You will see that they're running this in a L4, but it's probably even, well, for sure it's not even need. You need and spending only 3.8 gigabytes of memory, loading with the 16 brain float data type, the model, and doing the experiment. Really, in my opinion, quite impressive what they did with this small model. You can see the written documentation, the papers that they provide. It's a model designed to run in a small, with short environments where you don't have available powerful GPUs, and also there is limited memory. It's also very fast. The model is responding very, very quickly as well. And again, just take a look, try it. You can follow us later on, the same, use the same notebook in your local environment, and you can test it yourself with other prompts if you want. I do it with the COT because you will see now, you can compare as well with the other models in the notebooks are available on the repository, and then you can take a look to the test I did with code Llama 7B, Llama 2, 7B, Llama 3.8B, Llama 3.8B. Some of them are just the testing with the with these prompts that you will see here, and some others are the same test after fine-tuning the model with a data set, with the a specialized data set in COT, in chain of truth. For those that are not familiar with COT, it's just a way to do a special prompting where you provide an example. It's orientated to do reasoning or algebra or mathematical questions, and then you just provide an example. And together with the it's an specialized fuse of prompting, you can introduce more than one example, 1, 2, 3, etc. In the case that you will see today with the V3, the impressive is that I'm doing zero soft prompting with this chain of through kind of chain of through or reasoning questions, and you will see that all of them are answered correctly. This model, that is quite impressive in comparison. Again, I did this test, all of them fail the most complex questions. You will see it at the end of the video in this test. And all of them, even the GPT 3.5 Turbo failed the question. And for my test, the only ones who passed it was GPT 4.5 Turbo and Gemini Pro 1.5. Those two were the only two models which solved this prompt correctly. The other ones failed all of them. You can take a look in any case in the repo. You had everything there. Again, Llama or Mistral, we did the same. Mistral 7B and also the fine-tuning models. I will do as well a fine-tuning notebook. Probably with the same notebook, just to do an example. But in this case, believe me, you will see now the output is really not necessary. We are going to spoil the model if we fine tune it. For this specific case, so you need to decide it is really worth it to do the fine tuning for this specific topic, or you can just keep using the model as Microsoft delivers. Okay, so let's go. Just import the libraries we need to do the inference. We load the model from Hugging Face. Yes, again, this is the URI. You had the 4K version and the 128 version, both. So also keep an eye this the size of the context length of this model for, and the size of the model is impressive, the model in my opinion. Let's check now. So we load the model here. You just get the footprint. We are loading the model with the BrainFroad 16 in our CUDA device, in our GPU. Here just we make a test, just a short question, you can ask whatever. And now we start here with the questions, no? And then again, it's zero soft prompting. I do one of them, but it was not necessary even. With zero soft COT prompting, which is just including this sentence, which is demonstrated that the force or drive the model into break down the rationale that is using to solve the question. But well, again, you will see that it was not even necessary to introduce this. No, this is proof that using this, you can take a look to the paper. It was demonstrated that just introducing this sentence, the models react and they are able to break down the problem in small pieces, and then on answer you correctly with only zeros of prompting. But yeah, I tried this with the previous ones, with the Llama 3 and all the previous examples, and even in the last prompt I used, it didn't work. In this case, it was not even necessary. So first question, I make just a list, and then I ask the model just to use to provide as response the sum up of the numbers in the list. And well, you can see here it's pretty simple question, but you know, for models, for LLMs in general, this kind of mathematics or questions where you need to use a common sense or some rational, they are very hard for them, and then you need to, well, first of all, be very specific, in many cases provide examples, and also in many cases provide examples like in this specialized chain of truth prompting, like using this technique. But again, here no even need zero source prompting, pure zero source. You just give the instructions, provide the question. You just made the question in the instruction, and that's it. You see here, I asked, obviously the answer of this summing up the numbers of this list is 852. Yeah, you can see here the model is answering correctly. Here I make a second question. This is the problem of apples. I bought 10 apples. I gave 2 to the neighbor, 2 to the repairman, and I bought again 5 more, and I ate 1. How many remains? This is well, pretty simple mathematical problem. Remains again 10 apples, and you can see here that the model is also answering correctly and also explaining the rationale behind of the answer, which is really again impressive. Take your own, how to say, impressions of how the model works with your own prompts, but again, it's, in my opinion, it's a model that we should keep an eye on it. Here another question, here we have, when I was 6, my sister was half of my age. Now I'm 70. How old is my sister? 67. Yeah, for us it's quite easy to answer these questions, but again, for the model this is not that trivial. And then you can see here, so when you were 6, how old your age, the age of different sisters 3, so that time 67. Take a look to the other notebooks and you will see that this question as well, Mistral didn't answer correctly, for example, and also Llama 2, Llama 3 answered correctly. Then on another question, here I had a cat 20 years ago, and that time I was 37, how old I am now? 57, pretty simple this question, at least for a human, probably a young of 15 or 14 years can answer this without any problem. But again, for an LLM, These questions are very hard. 57, also correct. And also that was the one that all of them fails, except again GPT 4.5 Turbo and Gemini. But compare the models, compare the money that they Google and OpenAI spend to train those models in comparison with this nano model, because this is a nano model in comparison with GPT 4.5 or Gemini Pro. This is nada, 1,000 times smaller, if I'm not wrong. Just keep make a comparison, probably a little bit less, but well, very very small in comparison with the others. And then again, you can run it in a T4, which is something that today is even I know that probably I'm using some T4 machines in Azure. They are costing $1,000 per month, so you can deploy a model, but you don't need even that model for inference. You can even use a small GPU to just do the inference. You can take a look here. The memory footprint is 7.11 gigabytes. Probably we load in int 8. We should take a look what happened if we load the model in int 8 or int 4, and if they are still keeping the same performance. But well, for now, just for this test, to do the initial comparison with the other models, is more than enough. So we were here, the last model, the hardest one, the depreciation of the car. So I had a car 20 years ago. The car cost $100,000. Car annual depreciation is 5%, and using the declining balance method, what is the value of the car now? So here this is the same, but without using less think step by step, without using COT, zero shot COT prompting. And you can see here the model answered 35,848.59, which I had the table here, which is correct. It's incredible. And here I do the same, just introducing less, just to be consistent with the other experiments, and well, the model also answered correctly. Again, I think you can do the similar experiment with your own prompts. Again, I'm using these prompts because I know that with the other models was very hard for them to solve these tasks. And the models were even bigger than this one, and then you can see here that with very very small model in comparison with the others, even the hardest questions are correctly answered. So my opinion, something that we need to keep an eye on that and see, and something that probably is how to say, something that you can evaluate to use it in some of the activity that you probably are doing, because this model is performing with that accuracy, no, in the answer being so small for many things that you probably are thinking to deploy, you can use it cheap. You don't need to. You can run it on premise. You don't need to have a connection to internet. You can deploy things more or less. Conventional infrastructure, you don't need anything special, a simple GPU to do this. You don't need to spend hundreds of dollars just to build the infrastructure. A machine with a GPU, more than enough to do the inference, and you have a model with very good numbers, especially in many of the benchmarks that it was evaluated, and you saw here the experiment, the model is performing very very well. Test in your local environment, and you can get the same, or maybe try with other prompts and check it. You get the same outputs I got. Again, take a look to the documentation. You can see here How good is this model, this small model, in comparison? Look at this benchmark. Here is the COT, essentially. Benchmark, it is a and then take a look how good is the model in comparison with the other. Essentially, the model, they say, the explanations that the model is. It was designed to work high quality and reasonable reaction intense properties. So the model was especially trained for putting focus on this specific tax, but yeah, here common sense, language understanding, math code, long context and logical reasoning. So but if you have you need to work with something that you need a model with these features, I think this is a very good choice for many of the tasks or many of the or in comparison again with others that are bigger than this one. Okay, that's all. I will upload the model, the notebook into the repository, and I will give you a link. I will put you the link in the description of the video, and that's all for now. I'm thinking in what to do in terms of the it just fine-tune this model using the same the same data set I use with the other ones, or just use another one just to give you an example of how to do a fine tuning. But in my opinion, doing a fine tuning specifically for COT in this case is spoiling the model, and we are going to get a catastrophe for getting the probably just trying to get a slightly better performance, but not even worse for that specific for this specific topic tax, no chain of through, and then I don't think that it should be we should do it. No, it's probably it's better to use it like Microsoft originally released specifically for this activity, for chain of through or for this kind of activities. Okay, that's all. Thank you very much for watching my video, and again, subscribe to the channel if you are not already subscribed. Give me a like if you like the video, share with your friends and colleagues just to help me to promote the channel. Thank you very much. Bye.